Thank you for joining in. We're finally getting to the kitchen tour. And some people may think, well, what does a kitchen tour have anything to do with Atkins or induction or a diet or a weight loss plan? In my opinion, it has a lot to do with it. Diets and weight loss start in the kitchen. It's a place where you can be creative and imaginatory and it can inspire you. It could also be a tricky place at times. I feel like I do a lot of justice in my kitchen to make it induction friendly. So I hope that I can give you guys some hints and tips, or hopefully even some organizational advice maybe. Now, I'm not rich by any means. My kitchen is very small, it's very little. I'm very grateful for it. I've utilized the space, as best as I think I can. So, I'm sorry if you're like, "Ooh, I would really put that in some baskets," or "I would really, oh, that would get on my nerves." It's me. I'm the lady of the house, so this is how I have it set up. And without further ado, we'll go ahead and get started. So right now we're actually in my dining room, and you go towards the kitchen. I'll give you guys just an overview, I guess this will be the best way, of the kitchen. Again, nothing, fancy, or, I don't have top of line appliances. Anyway, I'm just gonna be quiet. Here you go. So that's my kitchen. And we'll go ahead and we'll go through it briefly. I hope we can get through this as quickly as possible. Let's do the cabinets first. So in the first cabinet here, all my small appliances. I used to keep them down below, but it's especially with Atkins, you need things to be more accessible. So here I have like a coffee. There's a mandolin there. I have a coffee pot maker, a coffee maker. And I have a juicer, some accessories. I have some dining trays, a rice cooker that you can use for cauliflower rice. My family is not all within induction. My husband is not an induction, so I still, make him things. I have a coffee grinder. We're huge coffee fans, and a mixer and a blender. And that's just in there, so I can get to it really easily. These red dots I'll put in a helpful tips video. You'll kind of see why I have them throughout. This is probably the most helpful cabinet, and this is my container cabinet, I guess. As you see, my paper products are there. Here's some holiday napkins, regular napkins, some backup napkins. I have gloves, a tablecloth. Here I actually keep my water bottles, my thermos. Here, and I'll go into, here's my funnels. This right here is just where I keep all of my, oh, bad lighting, sorry, all of my plasticware. And then I have all of my paper products. I have a apple slicer and some toothpicks. And here is my biggest help ever. It's just simple containers, but by keeping them so easily to be able to reach up and grab them, makes it really easy to store leftovers and measure out foods and things of that nature. So here I keep the lids in this old napkin box, which works out really well. I can just kind of go through it and pick the lid that I need. And then here I have some, just assorted, how exciting is containers. But I really love these little ones. They come in a pack of eight, I believe. And they're wonderful for dressing or, heavy cream. They're a little wet from washing them, but heavy creams. I put like a creamer in here, and I use it in my coffee. Sour cream, salsa, side dishes, cheese, you name it. And those little containers really do. They're definitely efficient. So that is there. In the back here is my two cup measuring, my measuring cup. Here is where I keep all of my measuring spoons. I could not keep them all together. It just was impossible. So I just toss them in here. When I use one, after it's clean, I just toss it. And it's just helpful to just keep it in a larger area. Here I have probably, four incomplete sets of measuring cups, but between the four, I'm bound to find what I need. And I just keep them in this kind of like this cheap plastic little containers here. And it's so easy to just pull them in and pull them out, and I'm ready to go, and I got things packed. Much easier than fumbling through. So that's what I have in that cabinet. What you will notice is I have a spice rack right here. It came with spices, but I mainly don't use the spices it came with. We use a lot of Mediterranean spices. So I also have, this is cabinets, all spices. This is a helpful hints. We can go ahead and we'll go over it on my helpful hints video. But I basically keep empty water bottles and I refill them at the grocery store. Here's all of my spices. When you're doing induction, it's really good to have an array of spices. And these I keep and I refill them, you know, the containers, and I just keep them here and they're all right here. Here are backup, you know, spice things. In the back is oats, and I keep it out of sight because I can't have it. And here's just some more backup spices and some baking items as well, some nuts, and this is actually ginger, fresh ginger that we use quite often. Some prunes, some cinnamon, here's some rosemary. So that's everything in there. Up at the top, these right above the stove, I have my lunch boxes here on that side, and I have books and recipes and some games on this side. Anybody familiar with this, you can actually order it on Atkins.com. It comes with some really helpful tools. I keep the box as a reminder. I believe there is a guide in there, and there's a really helpful, I actually have two of these, and I keep one in my purse. It's a carb counter that you get free by going to Atkins.com, so just a quick tip. Just some cookbooks and recipes and things of that nature. So nothing too exciting in this cabinet, but I do have my lunchbox array in there, if you will. Here is the pantry. This is a little harder to explain. Like I said, my husband's not on Atkins. So, you know, there are some things that are not Atkins friendly, and everything that's really not Atkins friendly is at the top. So we have the pasta, the couscous, the rice. I used to make sushi prior to Atkins, so I have all my sushi supplies there. On below is just a few items, some cooking items, pancake mix. I have some popcorn for him and just some canned goods there. Nothing too much. I mean, it's just two of us. So that is my whole entire pantry. And that's right next to the stove. And we have a little basket there. These are all vitamins. All my vitamins, supplements, protein powders, everything like that is in this cabinet here, which I really need to, I never remember to take them, which is a shame. Here next to that one is just where I keep, I have bowls, glass bowls, glasses, plateware, tea, big tea and coffee drinkers around here. There's always caffeine no matter where you look. So there is all of my tea glasses and teapots. Very proud of that, and we'll go ahead and close that up. In here is where all the coffee and teas are. So here is teas. I'll try to go through them. Teas from China, tea, jasmine tea, green tea, herbs to put in tea, regular tea bags, more herbs, a cappuccino mix my cousin gave me, thank you. Here is a little basket filled with like flavored teas, hot chocolate mix for guests, and a quick coffee, you know, Wawa coffee, a lighter if we need to, and a few spoons, and I think right here are some stirrers, and then that goes in here. When we're on the run, we do use these disposable cups, coffee cups for hot beverages, so that's in there. We prefer the Pike Creek coffee. Pretty expensive, but it's very delicious. I have some sugar-free cappuccino, some coffee. I have some ground up top, some stevia, and some sugar. and up top is just a percolator and a coffee French press. And then here's where I keep all my pens, because trust me, in the kitchen you need pen where you accumulate pens. So I just decided to design that for pens. Okay, so that's actually all of the cabinets. We'll go ahead into the drawers now. I'll try to do it quicker. I'm sorry. This is where I keep tape if I want to close things up, knife sharpener, you know, an array of some baggies, aluminum foil, and I use this all the time. You know, I'm constantly bagging things. Here's my small appliances. Right next to the stove, I keep spices and appliances, like not appliances, but utensils rather. So here I have like a, you know, just a few, as you can see, just a few utensils there. Here are just more spices. They're right next to the stove, so they're quick and easy to put everything in. We have an array from chili powder to garlic powder to paprika to cumin to turmeric, and then we have even some very special saffron here, and some ginger, obey, everything, bouillon cubes. Here is my utensils that are right next to the stove, so it makes sense. Spatula, spoons, two whisk, and things of that nature. Here is my silverware drawer. I use these scissors all the time, so I keep them right there. Here's silverware, nothing exciting about that. Here's my knife drawer, so I just prefer them to be this way lined up. I also have my peeler in there, and those are my knife collection, two steak knives, two people. Here I keep my china set, and I have a lot of glasses. I think there's like 18 to 20 there. There's 20 plates. There's a milk or cream bowl and a sugar bowl, and this is for basically company, but they are one cup size, so I do happen to use them a lot for coffee and for tea. And then here, actually, I just keep like extra oven mitts and things for teas and napkin holders. And in the bottom one is just receipts and warranty and product information. Underneath the cabinet, not too exciting. I just keep, trash bags and dish detergent. And in here I have, you know, my sprays, and on here just my cleaner. I have a scrubber and some additional oven mitts. And we're done with the drawers and the bottom cabinets. This will start here. This is where I'm so sorry for the lighting. That's really terrible. That's awful. I'm so sorry. This is where I keep all my pots and pans lined up, usually by size. I have oils in here. It's olive oil. There's, I believe it's canola or vegetable oil. I keep my onions in a vase. That may be weird, but to me, this where they, you know, it's in a dark, cool place and they get air circulation. I have an extra bag of onions there. And my strainer and shredder and lids. And that's all that's in there. Hopefully this one may be like a little better. Here I have like some appliances I couldn't fit up there. So there's a crock pot, George Foreman, and plastic bowls, glass bowls, and serving dish trays, Moroccan style, I guess. So that's there. And then this is where I keep the trash can. I'm not going to open it because it's not that. Yeah, it's just trash can. Here's where I keep backups. So here I just ice cube trays, pitchers. I have extra sugar, coffee pots, extra of those cups, and yeah, that's everything. That is, yeah, my entire kitchen. So cappuccino maker, use that every single morning. That is it. I hope you guys enjoyed. Again, keeping helpful things such as measuring devices, you know, keeping everything in arm's distance that you're going to use a lot is really beneficial. And I hope this video was helpful. I don't know. But if you liked it, if you want to, you know, see more tours, let me know. The next video coming up is what's in my fridge. That's why I'm not doing my fridge, because I'm just going to do a tour anyway. You can stay tuned for that. And after that will be probably the helpful hints video. So until then, guys, thank you for watching. Thank you. You know, if you subscribe, I really do appreciate it. And I hope you guys have a good evening. So talk to you later. Bye.